Hello and welcome to my tutorial on the Pythagorean theorem. The Pythagorean theorem provides us with the relationship among the three sides of a right angle triangle. So we could ask ourselves what the right angle triangle is. It's also known as a right triangle. A right angle triangle is a triangle that has two of its three sides meeting at a 90 degrees angle, and that the hypotenuse is the longest side of the right triangle. This is an example of a right triangle. Two of its sides meet at a 90 degrees, and then the hypotenuse is the longest side. In this case also, we have two sides meeting at a 90 degrees angle, and the longest side is what we refer to as the hypotenuse. So, the Pythagoras theorem, it states that, the Pythagorean theorem states that the relationship among the sides of a right triangle is a squared plus b squared equals c squared. Yeah, if we draw the triangle, the right angle triangle, and then name the perpendicular side as let's have the perpendicular side as a and the base as b and the hypotenuse as c. So the Pythagorean theorem states that the square of this side plus the square of this side equals the square of this side. In essence, it's the square of the perpendicular side plus the square of the base equals the square of the hypotenuse. This is the Pythagorean theorem. So, given two sides of a right triangle, we can use the Pythagorean theorem to get the third side. An example here, like in example number one here, we are having a right triangle. And remember, the Pythagorean theorem only works for right angled triangles. So in this case, we are having a right triangle with a side 3 units, 4 units, and then the hypotenuse C units. So how can we find C? To find C, we use the Pythagorean theorem, that is A squared plus B squared equals C squared. So A is 3, B is 4, and C is what we are looking for. So 3 squared plus 4 squared equals to C squared. 3 squared is 9, and 4 squared is 16, which is equivalent to C squared. So C squared is equivalent to 16 plus 9, which is 25. So if C squared is equals to 25, then C is equals to the root of 25. So C equals to 5. So the hypotenuse of this right triangle here is 5 units. In the second example, we are having a right triangle. Two of its sides meet at a 90 degrees angle. So we are having the hypotenuse given as 13 units, and the base as 12 units, and now we are looking for the perpendicular side. So we are going to use the Pythagorean theorem, which says that A squared plus B squared equals to C squared. So A squared plus B squared, B is 12, so 12 squared equals to 13 squared, 13 equals to C. So that A squared equals to the positive 12 squared crosses the equal sign, it becomes negative. So that we have A squared equals to 13 squared minus 12 squared. So that A is equivalent to, if A squared is equal to that, then A is equivalent to the root of 13 squared minus 12 squared. So A equals to 13 squared is 169, 12 squared is 144. So 169 minus 144 is 25. So A is equivalent to the root of 25. So A, this side, is equal to 5. So the perpendicular side of this right angle triangle is equal to 5 units. And that's all about the Pythagorean theorem. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more.